Hello everyone. In this video, we'll see how to easily create these embroidery effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop Beta. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go ahead and open Photoshop Beta. Now, before we're gonna proceed with this video, make sure that you are having the latest updates from Photoshop Beta, because that's where you're gonna find the embroidery filter in the parametric filters. Alright, so I will go and open one of the fabrics in here, because I want to apply this on our fabric for it to be looking really cool. And I will go and open this logo from my channel. Alright, now this filter, it can be applied on an image or a text, logo, whatever you want. And also, it can be applied in a one color like this. But if you want it to look maybe a little bit cooler, you can just make choose a logo that it have different color for it to look cool. For me, I'm gonna apply a gradient overlay for us to have different colors in this. So I will go and open the blending options, and then I will choose gradient overlay. And as you can see, I already have blue to orange linear gradient, very simple one, and that is okay. All right, now we'll go to filter, and I will choose parametric filter. And as you can see, this is the new embroidery filter that you will find it in here. If you can't find it, you can just search for it, but I'm sure if you already updated your Photoshop Beta, you will find it in here in the top. And by the way, if you want to know how to make this effect without using this filter, just let me know in the comments below and I will try to make a video about it. Alright, so I will just one click on it, and this will apply it directly to the text. I mean, not directly, it will make a copy of it, which is very useful. And it will open this parametric properties that we're gonna actually play with. All right, so now the first thing that I want to do is to actually change the resolution from medium to ultra, just to have a better quality. And I will close this and I will zoom in for you to see how cool this is. Now, because I applied grading, you can see the colors, they are like actually classified in 8 sections. As you can see, if I open the parametric filter, you will see that if I drop down in here, let me actually put this up. All right. If I go down, you can see there is color 1, color 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, until 8. All right, and also we have it in here, the numbers of color. You can choose between 1 to 8. Now, this is really cool. You can keep it like this if you want. But for me, I prefer to have like 2 colors to 3 because I can manage them better. Because each color, you can manage it from the design and the orientation of it. So, I mean, this is cool if you want to manage all of them. But for me, I think I will change the number of colors to 2. And then I would go down to the colors and I would change the design from satin to twill, because I really like the twill one better than the satin. And I would do the same for the color too. I would change it to twill. And if you want to change the orientation of it, you can do that. For me, I think this looks cool. But if you want to do that, you can go ahead, for example, in the color 1, you can change the orientation to 90 degrees and see how it looks. So this is how it will look in 90 degrees. For me, I won't do that. I will keep it to auto. And the other thing that I want to do is to change the color of this purple to blue, and I will keep the orange. The purple one is in the color 1. As you can see, it will give you the option to custom the color. So if I check it, it will give me to choose a color. So I will choose a bluish color, something like this. All right, so I think it looks cool. Now, this is 100% experimental. You can go and play with every details that you have in here. For example, you can change the density. I mean, the lower you go, the bigger it will look. As you can see, if I go 80, you will see how the stitches will look very big. For me, I don't like this. So I'm just going to change it to between like 150 to 180. Yeah, something like that. But keep in mind, this actually depends on the resolution of your document too. So all the number in here, they need to be attached with the resolution and everything. Yeah. So the other thing that I want to mention is the style of the embroidery. You can change it from fill to outline. And, you know, you can choose between both of them if you like. This one, you can do that. This one, it has the fill and the outline. And also you can change the tightness of the fill and outline. I mean, everything in here is clear because all the options it have, it's attached with the name and everything. For example, I can go down with the fill and outline and this will be even smaller like that. Let me go back and let's actually keep its fill and outline for now. And let's try to play with the thickness. So let's actually play with the fill height a little bit. It's like this to make it a little bit down. Yeah, I think it looks really cool like that. And the other thing I want to do is to play with the thickness, maybe 0.3. Yeah, maybe not that much, maybe 0.4, and see how it will look. Yeah, I think this is much better. As you can see, it's up to you if you like it or not. And the same goes with the thread. I mean, the thread is the material that's been used to stitch or yarn on the fabric, basically, to make it look like this. Now you can go and play with the edges, maybe make them a little bit smoother, but I don't recommend to go very high because a lot of details will disappear the smoother you go. The other thing that you can do is actually, if you are satisfied with this and you really like all the settings that you put in here, you can actually add this to your library by one click on this plus icon. You can give it a name, maybe call it Stitch 1 and choose Create. And now whenever I want to apply the same thing, I can go and choose stitch and this would apply it for me. All right, now the last thing I want to do is to maybe put a little bit of shadow on this. I will go while I'm selecting, let me just put this in here. While I'm selecting the embroidery style, I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options. And then I will apply a drop shadow, very simple one. Maybe not that much. So I want to be very careful with the size and the distance, maybe 2 pixels for the size and 1 pixel for the distance. And I will keep the angle set to 90. And let's see before and after. And maybe I will drop down the opacity to like 70%. And I think that will be all. As you can see, so this is before and this is after. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick video and this was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know, wait for more to come and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.